engaging in some orange drink this evening and some blue drink, according to Neo Shaman, Jane Doe, John Doe. Orange being the drink of coffee because it awakens one to rationality, i.e. the concrete objective reality in which we face into in some regards. Really crafted in the 17th century, again, the Industrial Revolution. Blue drink, beer, this is the primary drink of the evening for me. Blue in the sense that it's one in which there's a bringing of camaraderie, lesser than conventional. Your awareness gets decreased from the conventional, from the rationalist perspective. It is conventional, rather. I apologize. And I just came back from watching a very conventional level movie, in a sense, although probably peeking into rationals, so this is very fitting, the chemicals of the evening for me. Again, according to John Doe, Jane Doe, again, worthwhile watching videos on YouTube. You might only understand 6/10 like myself of it, but it's worthwhile watching. It's the unconscious mind. Abduction, a dolphin story. Age rated for about 16-year-olds. Level of psychic intrusion, great. Great. Psychic infiltration, great. What do I mean by that? Potentially. Hold that as a potentiality, not as an absolute reality. I don't say that this is absolute truth, what I speak of. But I try my best. Especially under the influence, which I am not doing my best under. In other words, if I was of clear mind, I could do better than this. So, Abduction, a dolphin story. Again, directed at about 16-year-olds. This film circles around, dances around, mingles about the idea of CIA agents mutually penetrating the globe. In other words, this is a messy world, as they say. Martin, the young chap, the individual that I can't remember the name of, the lead character. His father turns out to be, I'm sorry, this is a spoiler alert. A little late, but this is a spoiler alert. His father turns out to be the CIA agent. CIA agent in which he's got a level 5 pass from the Geneva Accord. Beer. See, I'm drinking beer. I'm a little bit drunk. He's got a level 5 pass from the Geneva Accord in which he can kill women and children. I could get arrested here. I've got alcohol and people can see me. I've got... But he's got a level 5 pass to murder women and children. And this is all right in the end. This is just fine and dandy. Yes, we can't know about it. Because the super secret top secret government, the top secret government is allowed to dance around morals. They can murder women and children, that's just fine. I mean, a little simplistic. I am. Don't get me wrong. But okay, so this individual, He has that ability, and he kind of suggests that he's done it before in the way that he speaks. So let's just hold the idea, not the fact, because it's not a fact. It's an illusory story in some sense. But so this main character's father has murdered women and children, right? Okay. And this young boy goes through a traumatic experience, and it's truly traumatic, it really is. His foster parents get murdered. His young love goes along with him on this adventurous adventure in which a great Russian group come after him and track him extraordinarily well with technology that is above and beyond what you might think possible, maybe. although they're pushing this a lot. Anyway, these Russian people actually show their badge at the early goings, in which there's a pyramid. It's a really quick flash, but I'm about 98% sure that's what I saw. You know, pyramid. Think about pyramid symbology. Anyway, that's on the badge. Fuck it. Okay, so these people are trying to kill him because it turns out he has a cell phone that has encrypted information about state senators' secrets. One of the CIA agents that is protecting the young chap is one of those people on the cell phone in which a state secret is held in. So he seems to, although it's not explicitly made explicit, that this individual wants to, the CIA agent, wants to kill this young chap. Or at least wants to steal the cell phone and probably, well, if he knew about the information, he'd want to kill him. And he does know about it. So, anyway, a lot of this is subtle subtext for 16-year-olds, which are just not quite smart enough, but close. They're, especially this young age, this young group of people. But it is, it's covered up. I'm just barely smart enough to know what's going on there, I think. And I might be crazy, so. Anyway, that story. I'm fucking drunk. Kind of. So this individual is trying to catch the young chap to get the cell phone back. His father is simultaneously kind of looking over his shoulder, metaphorically speaking, and protecting him. But remember, he has a haunting past. In the end, I'll just sum it up. I have 3 minutes. In the end, his father does, in fact, save his life at a Pirates game. Black Pirates. P with a gold. Pirates game. And, shoots the, Russian. And, gets the CIA agent kind of caught, but Martin is certainly free. I'm really not doing a very good job of this, and I apologize. But there's a lot of symbolism here. It's not really overt, but in another sense, it is very overt. That they're speaking about a messy world in which murder of innocence is under certain contexts okay. So hold that space. Try to understand that space, because that's the world we sort of kind of are living in. Holy fuck.